Fossil fuels continue to heavily contribute to global warming. Today, as the prices of fossil fuels skyrocket, sustainable alternatives of thermal energy are sought after. One option would be reusing the excess thermal energy produced by small and big industries. But how can the industries detect their potential waste, heat or cold production? And if they are producing an excess, how can they find a consumer in need? A promising solution is offered by an innovative digital platform developed within the EU research project EMBERS. The platform calculates capacities and maps the demand and supply of waste heat. Thus, it is able to suggest the most cost-effective option to connect potential energy providers with users.
The main inspiration for it was to develop a tool, which is the EMBERS platform, that aims at matching excess thermal energy sources and sinks. And so basically we want this tool to be widely used across Europe. Reusing the excess thermal energy in the industrial processes or for other sectors, for example, to be used for a district heating network, for being used in buildings.
All these complex synergies and analyses can be computed by the EMBERS platform, which was put together by Lisbon-based IT experts at PDMFC.
The main difference is that the platform is much more user-friendly than the other ones that were around. And we hope more complete and more precise in its simulation results.
Tests on the platform have been carried out in a middle-sized industrial zone located in Volos, Greece. Using the EMBERS platform, four sources of waste heat in this area were identified. Their rejected heat is computed to be approximately 14 million kilowatt hours per year. If reused, this would be the amount of energy needed to heat the homes of a village with 7,000 inhabitants. The Viopar Energy SA biomass power plant is one of the identified sources.
The Viopar SA biomass power plant burns olive pomace and olive pit residues to produce electricity. And one of the byproducts of this whole process is flue gas from the chimney, which you can see there, and also waste heat from the air condensers, which we can see here.
To be able to use this waste heat, one would have to place a heat exchanger first in the chimney and then on these condensers.
Within these condensers would be water, which would be heated up by the heat rejected and then transferred to our sinks.
Additionally, five sinks have been identified in this area using the platform. A village located 5 kilometers away could be another possible sink of heat, as they need heat for their homes and hot water. All this builds a successful case for energy symbiosis. As part of the EMBERS project, several stakeholders from across Europe have been providing data and testing the platform in order to assess the potential of using thermal energy recovery in their businesses. Some of them are based in Portugal. Located in Sizeles is Simpor, a cement manufacturing company. It participates in EMBERS to gain access to the unexplored potential of waste heat in its factory. One of the main sources of waste heat is found at the initial stages of the cement manufacturing process. Raw material is fed into the tower. The material falls through and then cyclones up to the kiln in counter-current flow with the gases. Gaseous temperatures of up to 2000 degrees Celsius are reached during combustion in the kiln.
We are using the heat to dry our residue-derived fuels, which nowadays represent about 25% of the overall input of heat to the kiln through fuels. We will use very soon to produce electric power, which means that we could generate about 7.5 megawatts.
This energy could potentially be integrated into the factory's existing or future manufacturing processes to raise energy efficiency and cut indirect carbon dioxide emissions. While Simpor plans to be its own provider of resources, About 200 kilometers away, Climespace, the energy supplier of the heating and cooling network in Lisbon's Park of Nations district, is participating in the Embers project in search of an alternative source of energy.
We run a turbine and we produce electricity, and this electricity is used internally and is supplied to the neighborhood around.
These neighborhoods were created for the Expo 98. Each building receives heating and cooling supplied via the tri-generation plant of Climespace. The buildings are connected by a network of 90 kilometers of pipes.
If each building had its own individual system, it will take years and years, decades, to have this energy transition in the whole neighborhood. Here, it will happen the very same day that we make our own transition. So now what we have to do is just to replace the way we produce chilled water and hot water by a new technology, by a new energy source. One of the possibilities is to use excess heat from an industrial facility or from somewhere else to replace the primary energy source, which at the moment is gas.
The Portuguese energy agency ADEN is involved in calibrating the Embers platform via a different data set. They are located in the heart of Lisbon. ADEN manages a database of the energy performance certificates of buildings. This certificate is mandatory by law and includes information such as the heating, cooling, and water heating needs of each building. This helps define the possible sinks in a given area.
The industries also need to report their energy consumption. And actually, they need to establish a plan for energy reduction. So we'll also use the information regarding the energy needs and the energy consumption to characterize our source.
The Embers platform combines information that is processed by different modules. Through this, it calculates cost and resource-effective sources of heat and suggests processes and equipment to prevent heat loss.
It would definitely be a benefit for the country because we don't have a lot of excess thermal energy reuse. I just think that it happens here and it happens a little bit throughout Europe, so it's not specific to Portugal. We're really trying to scale this up throughout and across the European Union.